In this tutorial, we'll be looking at the octagonal proportions in the mausoleum of the Taj Mahal. It's one of the most famous buildings in Islamic architecture, and generally it's considered to be one of the most beautiful buildings in the world. What I want to look at in this tutorial is the plan of the mausoleum of the Taj Mahal, and to see what we can learn by looking at the shapes. What we know generally is that Mughal builders liked the octagon, and we can see lots of octagonal shape in Mughal architecture in general. And we can see it in the shapes of the buildings. We can also see it in details. We can see it in the geometric patterns. So the Mughal builders trusted octagons to give them harmonious proportions. And this is what we will look at in more detail in this tutorial. The first thing we notice about the Taj Mahal mausoleum when we see it from the air, that it's octagonal. Its perimeter has 8 sides, 4 long sides and 4 short sides. So this is what you call an irregular octagon, as opposed to a regular octagon. So let's look at that in a little bit more detail. In geometry, there are 2 kinds of octagons: regular octagons and irregular octagons. A regular octagon is one shape. Irregular octagons come in many different shapes. Regular octagons can be drawn by placing 2 squares on top of each other, like you see here. The shape that's created in the middle is a regular octagon. Mughal irregular octagons generally look like this, or variations of this. This is what we're looking at in this tutorial. So if we assume that in Islamic architecture, in Islamic design, nothing is random, everything is deliberate, how did they make these irregular octagons? How did Mughal designers decide the relationship between the 4 long sides of an irregular octagon and the 4 short sides of an irregular octagon? This cannot be random. There has to be a system there. So the question is, what is that system? So let's look again at the Taj Mahal mausoleum from the air. And we can see the 4 long sides of the building and the 4 shorter sides, what they call the chamfered sides of the building. What is the relationship? When we look at it in a plan drawing, you can see the long side here and the short side here. What is that relationship? They did it like this. They did it by placing 4 regular octagons next to each other in a 2x2 structure. So 2 regular octagons at the top, 2 regular octagons below. This then creates by its outline an irregular octagon with 4 long sides and 4 short sides. And when you place that on top of the plan of the Taj Mahal mausoleum, you can see that that fits perfectly. So that's one mystery demystified. But there are other proportions that we can see as well when we look at this plan drawing again. We can see that the 4 chambers inside the mausoleum, they're octagonal. We can see that the screened structure around the 2 graves of Shah Jahan and Mumtaz Mahal is also octagonal. So then the question is, how do these octagonal spaces, shapes, relate to each other? The distance between them is unlikely to be random. So if it's not random, what is it? How, for example, do these 4 corner octagonal chambers relate to each other in distance? Well, the answer is that you can put 3 octagons between each chamber horizontally and vertically, and it fits perfectly. Once we've done that, we can add more of these identically sized octagons, and essentially filling up the space between the 4 chambers, and you can see that that also fits perfectly. So now we have a grid of 5x5 octagons, 25 octagons in total, that give us the proportions of the placements of the chambers inside the Taj Mahal mausoleum. But we're not finished, because we can add more of these identically sized octagons around this grid of 5x5 octagons. And when we do that, we can see that that also fits perfectly inside the plan of the Taj Mahal mausoleum, so that you end up with a grid of 7x7 octagons that give us the sizes of the interior spaces and the relationships between each of them. So let's zoom in a little bit and look at how the iwans are featuring in the plan drawing with the grid of 7x7 octagons superimposed. The E1s are the big openings at the side of the Taj Mahal, and they have a particular size, a particular length and width. And as you can see, that length and width is made by three octagons next to each other and then choosing a rectangle from the intersections from the angles that they create, like this. So to recap, the outer shape of the Taj Mahal mausoleum is created by 2x2 octagons, creating an irregular octagon made of regular octagons. That's the secret here, really. On top of that is a grid of 7x7 octagons that fits inside the outer perimeter of the Taj Mahal mausoleum. That also gives us the proportions for the E1s on all four sides of the Taj Mahal. So lastly, let's look at some of the remaining proportions in this building. The central dome is created by the small square in the middle of the 2x2 octagon grid that was used to create the outer perimeter. As you can see in this image, the circle fits perfectly on top of that. Now the last thing we need to look at are the E1s, the niches on the exterior of the building. Not the central big ones, but the smaller ones next to them. We first need to look at the octagonal grid again. So here's the grid that we're familiar with, but it's also possible to rotate this grid by 45 degrees so that it looks like this. And this rotated grid needs to be applied to the sides of the mausoleum to get the proportions of these niches. Let's have a look. So here are these niches in a plan drawing. And as you can see, we can place three octagons along the chamfered side of the building, along the short side of the building. Three octagons fit perfectly, and the octagon in the middle gives us the proportion of the niche in the middle of the short side. Then we can extend this grid by adding some more octagons, and you can see that these also give us dimensions that we need, such as the width of these other two niches that are sitting next to the big central niche. They are the width of one octagon. You can also see that the little squares in this grid give dimensions that are essential to the plan of the mausoleum. And then lastly, the depth of these niches on the long sides of the mausoleum, these are proportionate to the depth of the big central niche. So there's a fixed relationship there between length and width, just smaller size. So it's fair to say that the Mughals use the octagon in very many different creative ways. They trusted the octagon to give them dimensions that would always work, and they combined them in different ways to get different results. And there's more to explore, as I'll do in future tutorials.